Hello, I am Muchaneta to Napel, and I'm here at Munich Fabric Start with Annabelle, and she was on one of my panels, weren't you, this afternoon?
Yeah.
And I had to bring her to the couch and have a conversation because some of the points you're making were so interesting that I felt like, do you know what? You and I are going to have a one-on-one.
Yay.
But before we begin, do you mind introducing yourself to the audience?
Sure. So my name is Annabelle Hutter. I am the managing director of ntis Textiles. We are a family company. We are owned and run by my father, and I am now working in the Swiss office based out of Zurich. And what I do is I work to translate my father's work into the fashion industry. So my father built a recycling machine, and this recycling machine is the only machine that can textile to textile recycle waste into brand new fabrics for clothing. So we're the only company that can make 100% recycled cotton, and we have textile to textile grade recycling, which is very new for the industry.
So this is why I wanted you to come to my sofa, because this is something so interesting.
Yeah,
because it feels like, you know, it's can't happen. It's not true, you
right?
know? Because I hear a lot of brands and a lot of solutions saying that we can't have 100%, or we can't do this, or we
right.
can't do that material.
Right.
So how come, you know, you guys? I mean, don't tell me you're magic sauce or anything. But how is it possible? Because I feel like there's a lot of barriers to recycling.
Currently. Yeah, I mean, you can ask that question because basically our slogan is fiber-friendly recycling. Mm. But I think the reason why, you know, we haven't really been so heavily promoted is because, quite frankly, we are a family company and we do have a small marketing budget. Marketing budget involves just me being present.
Yes.
And my LinkedIn presence and some campaigns here and there. But really, our marketing is through the products. So the products that we do have, for example, with Tommy Hilfiger, like I was saying today with Alexander McQueen, that really is our marketing. So it has been a long time coming. But when I say fiber-friendly recycling, our recycling machines, we have two now, they focus on mechanically recycling with no chemicals, no bleaching, no water, no wetting of the fibers. And it basically means that we process the waste a lot slower than conventional recycling machines. And I think the industry is so familiar with the conventional recycling machines and have not had the chance to really come to us and work with us. Also, marketing is one point, but as well, because the capacity, we don't have the capacity to work with everyone, but we're trying to get there. And something I didn't mention on the panel was we are actually licensing our IP, so my father's proprietary technology, to the world, so that bigger machine makers can take the IP and build their own iterations of our recycling machines, so that we're not the only ones holding on to it, so that it can be out accessible to everyone and all the brands.
That is the best marketing tool right there, because
yeah.
a lot of people, when they have the innovation, they're not so quick to share it.
No, exactly.
It's not, you know, it's not like, why would I share it with you? It's mine.
Exactly.
But
exactly.
I do like this approach because I feel that a lot of the solutions should be shared.
Exactly.
Because the problem affects everyone.
Exactly.
It's just a matter of how you share it.
Right, right. And I think like 5 years ago when we started, and I was saying today that, like, you know, my father keeps saying that the train is really at the station still. When he started in 2016 to develop this machine, it was all about like the space race, I call it. Like, who's the Elon Musk of the industry, right? Mm. Who's getting like the savviest marketing? Who's getting like the coolest tech out there? Mm. And then now people start to see that there wasn't actually a product behind it. So then they start to retract, and then they're, you know, complaining that recycling's not really there. But my dad was just quietly in the background. He's not an Elon Musk by any means. He's great. Like, his brain is probably like as great, and it is. And I'm really proud of him, but he definitely did it reversed. You know, he was focusing on getting the product out, and he wasn't so great at marketing. He didn't want to prioritize a budget. All the budget that we do have pretty much goes into the R&D of this one machine. And I think another important fact to talk about is my dad also comes from the textile machinery industry. So my grandfather was in it, building machines, developing tech for machines, and my father was now like doing that as well as like technical fabrics. So he was never interested in the fashion industry, And that's why he hired me to kind of relate.
But you know
message.
What? I think those people make the best problem solvers.
Yeah.
Because how they view the problem is so different from how I would view it coming from fashion.
Yeah.
And they're actually able to solve it without that kind of like need to defend how we do business.
Right.
Do you understand where I'm coming
exactly.
from, right?
Exactly.
And when it comes to recycling in general, how can the fashion industry help you guys progress?
Yeah.
What role can we play
to
make sure that recycling becomes something that's actually accessible and achievable for the industry?
Right. So the brands that I do work with that I love working with, they're the ones who kind of look at things with an open mind and they're curious and they don't really say no. And they try to like find ways to integrate recycled cotton into their collections without asking too many questions or without sitting in that framework that they are used to and that they're comfortable in. Most of the designers, they want to go outside of the box. They want something different. And then that really works down the line for everyone. There's still a lot of brands who are very stuck in the mindset of, oh, we had this one experience with recycling and it was bad quality. And then they just think that it's all going to be the same thing. But you have to keep getting to the point. You have to keep waking up every morning and saying, I'm going to get, you know, the best out of my day. And that means finding new ways to address the problems in the industry. And that might mean taking a leap of faith on different innovations that are out there.
Do you know what it is? It's they fail to see the potential.
Exactly.
Especially when it comes to technology.
Exactly.
It's like, for example, seeing the first phone and then deciding in that moment that, oh my God, this first phone is in a suitcase. I'll never invest in it. But instead of seeing the potential of what that phone could lead to.
Right.
Now look at all of us with our little computers in our pockets.
Right. You know? Just carrying it around.
Carrying it around and be able to do
it
anything.
Anywhere.
Exactly. So my thing is that the fashion industry is not able to look at something and innovation and be like, I see the potential. I can see where this can actually go.
Right.
So with recycling, I feel like that's their experience has not been really that great. And a lot of them had a bad taste in their mouth. So now they feel like, oh no, we can't.
Yeah.
And they don't realize it's a journey.
Yeah, it is.
There's going to
really
be bumps
is.
In that road.
Yeah.
And the secret is actually keeping up.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Yeah.
You know, figuring it out.
Yeah.
If you can't go left, go right. Yeah. If you can't go down, go up.
Exactly.
You know, approach.
And we've been really hand-holding a lot of brands for so many years. And I think that's where you also build that relationship of trust. And we show them, we give them the access to our machinery and to our product. And so I think that is like a relationship evolving. And I'm really happy about it. You know,
maybe that is the solution.
Way. Yeah.
If they are able to have relationship with innovators such as yourself, solution providers such as yourself, that trust comes. I don't think trust with them comes quickly.
Right.
I don't think trust with them is automatic.
No, exactly.
It's a you gotta build it. It's
exactly. Like a,
so
keep
I
the
think,
communication lines open.
I know, but I kind of don't like the fact that you have to be in the job of convincing, though.
Yeah, I feel like I'm begging sometimes, you know. And then sometimes I tell my colleagues, I'm like, yeah, you know what? I'm not gonna sit here and sell myself. I know what I'm doing is the right thing, and that I believe in what we're doing. And this machine is there for everyone to see. If they don't want to see it now, they're gonna see it down the line. So. And we've had that instance where I come with products and I release it to the market and I promote it. And then we have some brands circling back and they're like, oh, I see you did this little thing for that brand. Ooh, tell me more. So it's also all about the product.
Because you know what it is? They are in waiting mode.
Yeah.
Consistently on waiting mode.
Yeah.
Who does it first? I'm going to watch what happens before I invest my money where, you know. But they don't realize that you are investing in your future.
Exactly. This
you
is
know.
Like also like my like dating advice. This is like therapy.
I know.
There's
because
so many
you know
parallels.
What I understand because you were saying so many key things on stage.
Right.
And I was like, do you know what? I'm going to get Annabelle in front of the camera because we need to have a one-on-one because I think we're on the same mindset of understanding that it's a journey. Understanding that recycling is something that, yes, it's got loads of problems and issues and it's kind of like not connected, but it can be connected if we all are in the same room.
And if we're
the same
all
table,
willing to learn and talk about it.
That's it. And I think that once everyone has that kind of like mindset, it will move faster.
For sure.
But it's getting there, right?
Yeah, we're getting there. We're getting there.
Slowly but surely.
Slowly but surely. And I think, honestly, with this machine license going out, I can't wait to see the different machines popping up in various supply chains. I'll be really happy once my dad can, like, retire seeing his machine maybe in, like, 10 factories doing their thing. So we have a lot of exciting things in the pipeline. So
see, I feel like I'm going to be watching you now because I want to see how you progress because you're very kind of inspiring and you're very positive as well.
Thank you. Yeah, you know what? I a lot of people are like, what are you taking? But I think you have to be, right? I don't like to be depressed and sad about, you know, what's going on in the world. I like to think about what I can do to make it a better place. And I know that sounds fluffy, but I really think if you keep that mindset, then it translates to all the work, you know, that we can do and that I have been doing. So
I think bring on the fluff.
Yeah.
I am happy with the fluff.
I think we need more fluff.
I think we need more fluff.
Less criticism, less negativity.
Yeah. Safe space, right?
Yeah. Safe space.
Oh, thank you so much, Annabelle, for finding the time. I know you're a busy lady. So thank you so much. And I wish you all the best.
Thank you. You too. Thank you.